The Epidemiology and Laboratory Capacity for Infectious Diseases Cooperative Agreement, or ELC, is CDC's national funding strategy for combating domestic infectious disease threats. This crucial CDC investment helps fund epidemiologists, support surveillance systems, modernize laboratory facilities, and develop flexible health information networks at state and local levels. Communities across America benefit from actions taken by U.S. public health departments to prevent, detect, respond to, and control known and emerging infectious diseases. The U.S. Virgin Islands has important public health needs for both their permanent residents and the many tourists who vacation there. This U.S. territory is located in a geographic region where mosquitoes that carry Zika, dengue, and chikungunya viruses are common. Inadequate laboratory capacity puts the island's public health system at a considerable disadvantage. That all changed in 2016.
Hi, I'd like to take a minute to talk about an important public health milestone in the U.S. Virgin Islands, which would not have been possible without support from the CDC Epidemiology and Laboratory Capacity Program. Until recently, the U.S. Virgin Islands was the last state or territory without a public health laboratory. In addition, the U.S. Virgin Islands did not have a clinical lab or a hospital lab capable of doing high-complexity testing. Most of our modern infectious disease tests are high-complexity tests. This has presented a problem in the U.S. Virgin Islands because most tests have to be sent off-island to the mainland.
Laboratory specimens shipped from the Virgin Islands to the mainland for testing historically have not been collected in sufficient quantity to allow for timely or evidence-based decision-making. This problem became evident in 2014 and 2015 when the Virgin Islands experienced a large outbreak of chikungunya. The epidemic spread rapidly among island inhabitants. Test results from blood samples show that one-third of the territory's population had been infected with chikungunya. The majority of infected people experienced severe and disabling symptoms temporarily or for prolonged periods of time.
In most cases, test results did not come back in hours or days or weeks, but months. And in some cases, testing took almost 8 months. This is clearly not acceptable, and the U.S. Virgin Islands needed to develop the capacity to do this testing on island.
So in 2014, the Virgin Islands Department of Health began working with CDC ELC to apply for funding to build this local laboratory capacity. And in 2015, the Virgin Islands was awarded this money. Success, right? Well, the story doesn't end there, because in 2015, Zika virus started to spread throughout the Caribbean.
Zika virus infection during pregnancy can cause microcephaly and other severe brain defects.
Thankfully, the Department of Health was already funded in the previous year to begin building laboratory capacity, and we've been busy equipping the lab and beginning testing. The Virgin Islands Department of Health is extremely appreciative of the funding that we have received, and it has an immediate impact, both in terms of surveillance and responding to this outbreak.
By the end of the chikungunya epidemic, the Virgin Islands Department of Health, using ELC funds, had significantly increased its capability to detect and respond to emerging public health threats. Perfect timing. A Zika epidemic hit the islands in 2016. Strategically placed resources like these highlight the crucial relationship between ELC and its local public health partners. For more information on CDC's national funding strategy for preventing infectious disease threats, visit cdc.gov/ELC.